We will show now another approach of the Riemann sums with TI N-Spire, more symbolic than the previous one. Let us show first the notations. We will start with a function, this one, and defined on AB, and a subdivision of AB in an interval with this notation a plus b minus a divided by n 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, k times, n minus 1 times, etc., etc. So what we will do is to try to create with piecewise function a such representation. This function representing the Riemann sums and the corresponding rectangles, and also these Riemann sums and their corresponding rectangles. So how will we do that? First thing to do is to define a, b, and n that can be changed during the manipulations. The function and one piecewise function defined like this when x belongs to one of these intervals of the subdivision and zero elsewhere. So let us see here what we want to show. You can see that it's this function defined here, and if we change the value of k, you can see that it's the value of the function on the left side of the interval, it's a constant, and zero elsewhere. So if we add all these functions, you know, is what we did here. See, sum of the previous function from 0 to n minus 1, it corresponds to this, yeah. From 0 to here, last value of fx, here we obtain the representation of function g, which is this one. Let us hide that. And if we ask the software to give us the integral of this function between a and b, we get this result. And if we ask the software to give us the integral of the blue function, which will be this area, we have this result. And we can see that this number is an approximation of this one for n equal 10. But if we change for n equal 20, we have a better representation. It's very long. But we will obtain that, and you can see that we are approaching better. But we will not continue like that. And let us come back to okay, and now let us see one of the function we have added and one of this rectangle. So you can see that if I change the value of h here, can go here and here and here, and here you have all the rectangles which areas give this number. We could do exactly the same thing for the other integrals, you know, for these functions which area give that, and we can represent the sum of all these functions, get that, and the Riemann sums are here. And you can see that here the integral is less than the sum of the rectangles. That completes this second approach of the Riemann sums.